we're in the cinema. Yeah, the wildlife and dinosaur park.
Oh, wow. Look at it.
Look at this.
Welcome to Key Mining Wildlife and Dinosaur Park.
Hi, Mr.
My name is Dynamite.
Hi, Dynamite.
I'm here today to talk to you all about dinosaurs. Well, there aren't many left,
it's
are there?
Like... Oh, there's none.
To explain this, I need to take you back. Back to the very beginning.
He's called Dynamite.
Back then, we were nobodies. We didn't even have names.
Aww.
But all this changed in 1842 when a well-known paleontologist, whose name was Sir Richard Owen, he gave us our first true identity. And we became known as Dinosauria, meaning terrible lizards.
Oh.
Paleontology is the discovery of history through fossil materials. The first nearly complete dinosaur was discovered in 1858 by a Victorian gentleman, fossil hobbyist, Mr. William Parker Fulk. The bones discovered were of an animal larger than an elephant with features of both a lizard and a bird. Fulk's first find in 1858 is marked as a spot where human fascination with dinosaurs first began. Perhaps one of the most famous dinosaurs is T-Rex.
Yeah.
Some believe the bacteria levels in his mouth are so high he could kill with a single septic bite with his 9-inch razor-sharp teeth and wait for his prey to collapse from his ensuing infection. Not so far-fetched when you consider the Komodo dragon, today's largest living lizard, uses such a septic bite when hunting.
No.
Our story starts some 248 million years ago.
Whoa.
The continents known as North and South America, Africa, Asia, and Antarctica were all joined as one. This supercontinent was known as Pangaea, meaning all lands in Greek. At the beginning of the Triassic period, there was the largest extinction of species ever known. About 95% of all species became extinct. However, around 10 million years later, during the Triassic period, there was the appearance of many new life forms. On land, the plants were mainly seed plants and conifers. There were no dinosaurs at the start of the Triassic period, but there were many amphibians. In the sea, corals appeared and ammonites reappeared. In the late Jurassic, the first mammals such as turtles, frogs, lizards, and even snakes appeared.
Whoa, look at that snake rolling down the hill.
The raptor was one of the first dinosaurs to appear in the Jurassic period, its name meaning dawn thief.
What?
Measuring only 3 feet long.
It is only 3 feet long.
It had sharp, pointy teeth, a light-built body, a long tail, long thin legs, sharp claws. Short arms.
Got a thing about being short, I think.
In the plant world, cycads became plentiful. The climate in the Jurassic period was hot and dry, causing desert-like conditions. However, there were heavy seasonal rains which formed rivers and lakes during the wet season. The dinosaurs back then were small, and most were quite similar.
Whoa, quite big. That does look quite an awful one, doesn't it?
The end of the Jurassic period was also marked by a mass extinction. Pangaea was beginning to break apart. There were huge volcano eruptions, and about 35% of animal species died out.
Whoa.
At the start of the early Jurassic period, the giant continent Pangaea broke up, the beginning of the world that we now know. There were huge volcanoes with rivers of lava and clouds of poisonous gases. Land that had been part of the interior of the huge continent was now coastline of a smaller continent, and the climate began to change accordingly. Forests of ferns, ginkgos, cycads, and conifers grew. Scuttling about at the bottom of these were the early mammals. The dominant land animals were the huge dinosaurs, the largest land animals ever. They were the gigantic herbivore sauropods, such as Brachiosaurus and Dilophosaurus. Diplodocus, meaning double-beaked.
Whoa.
He had a tiny head and brain.
Oh.
A huge gut to digest lots of plant materials.
Tiny head and brain, but a huge gut.
A long tail for counterbalancing its long necks. Four short legs to support it, and a long neck for grazing. Like the giraffe, Brachiosaurus probably roamed in small herds through low-lying forests. To drink, Brachiosaurus would have lowered his long neck towards the water like a giraffe. Its forward limbs were longer than its hind limbs, and its shoulders were raised above hip level. Brachiosaurus probably didn't have the advantage of a long tongue to reach for its food, so may have swung its head from side to side, cropping the vegetation with its chisel-shaped teeth. The dinosaurs of the Jurassic period were very different from each other because of the different climate. The carnivores such as Allosaurus, meaning different lizard, had to become larger, up to 38 feet in length and more fierce. They had clawed feet and large, powerful jaws. With long, sharp teeth to deal with such huge prey. At this time, there were many marine reptiles such as Plethiosaurus, Ichthyosaurus, sharks, rays, and crocodiles. The Cretaceous period marks the end of the age of the dinosaur. Big and small dinosaurs lived in great forests of cycads, conifers and ferns. There were great marine reptiles in the sea and great flying reptiles in the sky. Some things happened in the Cretaceous period that were important to life on Earth. One of these was the development of flowering plants. By the end of the period, there were many that we would recognise today, such as magnolias and water lilies. The number of different insects increased during this period too. The beginnings of many modern insects were at this time. Deinonychus was a light-built, fast-moving, agile, bipedal, bird-like dinosaur. Like this egret catching fish with a sudden movement of its head, Deinonychus might have snatched its prey and maneuvered it between its small jaws before swallowing its prey head first. Or when hunting along the riverbank like this bear, it may have grasped its victims with its claws while it tore it apart with its powerful jaws and needle-sharp teeth. Tyrannosaurus rex was a huge meat-eating dinosaur that lived during the late Cretaceous period. He was a fierce predator that walked on two powerful legs. Tyrannosaurus rex, meaning tyrant lizard king, grew up to 40 feet in length. He had a solid body and hollow bones. a slim pointed tail to provide balance, long powerful legs, large toes with sharp claws, tiny arms with two fingers and a huge head with large, replaceable teeth and strong jaw muscles. Rhinoceros gives us an idea of how dinosaurs like Triceratops moved. Triceratops walked on four legs and could reach high speeds when running. Triceratops, meaning horrible three-horned face, grew up to 30 feet. It had a large skull, three horns, and a large bony facial plate. A bulky body for storing food, a short pointed tail, and four sturdy legs.
Poor Triceratops.
The Cretaceous period ended with a bang about 65 million years ago. A mass extinction wiped out the dinosaurs and many other animals. Birds, small reptiles and mammals, many marine creatures and plants survived. Scientists believe a giant meteorite hit the Earth, causing massive destruction, tidal waves, acid rain, huge clouds of dust that block the sun's rays from reaching the earth to light and warmth. Other theories include high volcanism and climate changes due to continental drift. After the aftermath, we were left with places like Drumheller in Alberta, Canada, the richest dinosaur grave in the world.
It's
just where it happened to be when the continents broke apart.
This light-coloured rock is sand from a riverbed. The dark channel is the remains of mud, deposited from a flood when this area was completely submerged. It is in between these layers that dinosaur bones are most commonly found.
Wow. Wouldn't be cool, wouldn't it?
Extinctions, there was a slow recovery and evolution of new species. The age of reptiles came to an end. The age of mammals was about to begin. This brings us to the end of our journey. I do hope you enjoyed this brief introduction into the world of the dinosaur.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us at Coomartin Wildlife and Dinosaur Park. We hope you're having a great day.
Thanks,
do come again.
Bye. Thank you for the video. Bye, Dynamite. Say bye to Dynamite.
Bye, Dynamite.
Thank you for your information, it was very informative. Come on, let's go and see you, dinos.
Let's go and see the dinosaur park then, guys.
Yeah.